going on, my 40,000 amazing friends? I hope you're all doing absolutely amazing. I'm actually wearing my gown today. I did just graduate from university. Got this really expensive piece of paper right here. But all jokes aside, I did learn so much when it comes to the professional world, and I did make a whole bunch of contacts, but just a lot of stuff that you don't actually learn on YouTube that you actually learn in university is just, it's priceless. Well, it's not exactly priceless. It's pretty expensive. But yeah, today we're actually going to be, I'm going to get out of this first, and then we'll talk about the A7IV in low light situations, okay? Okay, that's better. Now, where were we? So the A7IV is a fabulous camera when it comes to low light situations. And as you saw by that intro, I shot a lot of that at ISO 6400 and ISO 10,000 in S-Cinetone. Now, this isn't the kind of situation I would normally shoot in, because if I am doing a whole bunch of professional stuff, I try and keep it at the base ISO as much as possible and add in lights, because lighting is one of the most important things when it comes to filmmaking. Trying to saturate that sensor full of light and not trying to underexpose it and try and bring it up in post. That is the worst thing you can do. But we're gonna be talking about the best settings for low light situations with the A7IV and things that you really need to consider before you start shooting. Because if you know your camera like the back of your hand, this makes it so much easier when you're actually out there in the field and trying to create the best image possible in camera. Because you don't wanna be fixing this in post. You don't wanna be adding noise reduction in post, because you start to degrade the image and you just wanna get the cleanest, best image possible out of the camera, and then you can start tweaking stuff in post. But there are a few things that you need to know about the A7IV first. So it isn't exactly a dual-based sensor, and that is very similar to the A7S III, mainly for the fact that the dynamic range is actually different in the two ISO levels. So to call it a dual-based ISO, technically, the dynamic range is pretty much exactly the same. So they've built the sensor so it performs perfectly the same at those two base levels. Now with the A7IV in S-Cinetone, you've got ISO 125, which is your first base, and technically your second base is ISO 500. So it is actually quite low when it comes to S-Cinetone. Now what you need to consider is that when you go from ISO 125 up to 200, 250, 320, 400, those ISO levels actually are worse than ISO 500, which seems a bit weird, right? Like, you wouldn't want to shoot at ISO 400. Your best bet is to actually crank it up to ISO 500, which is that second base, and you're actually gonna get a cleaner image, which blows my mind how that works, but that's just how the sensor is designed. So I do suggest try and stick around those base ISOs as much as possible. So S-Cinetone, 125 and 500. Now S-Log3 is a little bit different, and even exposing it is different as well. So S-Log3 on this one is ISO 800 and ISO 3200, whereas the A7S III is ISO 640 and 12,800. Very similar to the FX6, which I'm shooting on right now. That's 800 and 12,800 as well, dual base. Now with this ISO 800, you need to still expose by, you know, 1.3, 1.7 to 2 times overexposed on that sensor. So the little MM down the bottom there where it says multimetering or EV, that needs to say plus 1.3, plus 1.7 or plus 2. Now just be aware, if it says plus 2 and it's flashing like this, that's above 2 stops overexposed. So you want to crank it down so that plus 2 is just a static 2. 1.7 is what a lot of people say is the best. You need to overexpose, especially in that S-Log3 picture profile, because it really raises those shadows. And if you don't overexpose, you're going to have to bring it up in post, and that's gonna bring a whole bunch of noise. And that's not how you actually make these sensors perform the best that they can actually perform. So the difficult thing about oversaturating a sensor is when you are doing a whole bunch of run and gun stuff, it's going to be hard to overexpose by 2 stops, but you just need to understand the best performance out of your camera and understand what ISO levels are acceptable. So when it comes to grain or noise or electrical fluctuations, whatever you want to call digital noise, it really comes down to what is acceptable for the particular situation. If it comes down to just that particular client that does not like noise, then you really need to understand what noise is acceptable and what ISO levels you can actually shoot at, or definitely bring in lights if you can. Definitely bring in lights. That is one of the most important. I cannot stress how important getting perfect lighting scenarios are, because if you can expose the camera perfectly inside the camera, then post workflow is going to be absolutely amazing. You're not going to have to use any denoising. You're going to get a cleaner image. Everything will just look absolutely phenomenal. So take your time when you are actually shooting. If you do actually have time, if you're complete run and gun, that's a whole nother story. If you are a wedding videographer, that's a whole nother story. You're gonna have to try and be as prepared as possible, because I know when it comes to the first dance, I know when it comes to cutting the cake, lighting situations can be, you know, quite down, and it does become a little bit difficult. But all jokes aside, I just want to talk a little bit about this happy holiday season. And if you know someone is celebrating this holiday season alone, please send them a message, send them a DM, go visit them. That would be incredible, because I know there are a lot of people out there that don't have family or are stuck in isolation with the whole global situation going on right now. And I just really want to stress the mental health of everyone around the world at the moment. And if you know that they're celebrating Christmas or this holiday season alone, please send them a message, send them a DM, go visit them. That would be phenomenal, because mental health is really, really important. And the whole situation around the world at the moment, with a lot of people not being able to leave their state, country, and visit family members, it does get a little bit difficult. So I don't really want to turn this into that kind of video, but because this is a kind of a holiday season right now, I just want to, you know, spread this awareness and try and get people just to talk to someone, be with someone around this period, and definitely reach out to your friends, family members, someone you may not even know. You don't know how much that's going to help them. But anyway, my friends, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. That would be absolutely amazing. Subscribe to my YouTube channel if you already haven't. And guys, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, Happy Holidays, whatever you want to call it. Stay safe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Let's get it.